kuanza ukulima seriously nimeanza wakati nilikataa kufanya kazi Nairobi, kazi za ofisi. Nikaamua nirudi kwa shamba ya baba na mama, at least pia niwe nikilisha watu wa ofisi. Nikikombea na ile kilimo na ile mahindi nimekuwa nikilima. Kuna advantage ya tego na kuna disadvantage kwa mahindi yenye nimekuwa nikilima hapo awali. Inakuwa haraka. Inaenda kulingana na muda wake. Wakati baridi inakuja, haivunji mahindi ya tego. Na wakati hii ingine upepo inakuja, most of them inaanguka. Weather mwaka huu haikuwa constant, kukuanga na drought, kunakuwa na mvua. Lakini tego nayo, hiyo nini zote ina survive. Ni wengi wameniuliza, vile wanaweza pata hii mbegu juu. Wamekombea na hizi mbegu zingine na pandanga. Wameona hii kwa fadhali kuliko hizi zingine.
Tego nimefurahishwa sana jinsi inakuwa kwa haraka, tena iko na mahindi makubwa makubwa, tena naona kama maybe ni mahindi ambayo yanaweza saidia watu kuwaponywa na njaa.
Hata mbegu yenyewe naona ni mzuri, tena nimeona ni ya muda kidogo, nachukua kitu kama miezi tatu. Tarajia kupanda msimu huu, tena hiyo next year msimu wa mwaka, tena hiyo ndio nitarudia kupanda.
Ndio na hiyo jinsi mahindi yenyewe inapokuwa, na pia iko resistant kwa magonjwa, na vile wao mepanda 100 kwa 100, nikipanda eka mzima nitapata mahindi mengi sababu tayari nishanunua.
It has been with good efforts because this one is the third planting, and when I started I saw it was better than what I had in some other varieties. That's what brought me to plant tego, and I usually do look at the seeds well in time so that I catch up with the time, as our area here is so dry and usually we don't get a good harvest. We don't now rely on land to be short rains and long rains, so that's why we now embrace the tego to be the best, because whenever you think that you are planting in long rains, then it turns to be a short rain instead, because weather is unreliable. This is what I rely on for food and also for my animal feeds by so making silage out of it. So if I get the fast growing variety like a tego, then I know my animals will also do better with it, because even the residues we do feed them to animals. So I think it's a win-win situation whereby my house will have something for the daily food, and then my animals also will have the stovers for my milk production.
The aim of this project was to develop drought tolerant and insect pest protected maize smartful, you may say, a hybrid, white hybrid that will give royalty free to small scale farmers to improve their productivity, to ensure food security for them, and also create more income for them during period of drought. When there is drought, farmer loses crop, the yield, and we are hoping that instead of losing 100% of what material they are growing that are not drought tolerant, we give them material that are drought tolerant, that at least they can have some yield.
Farmers really like it. The few that planted it have got very good response. They say the germination percentage is about 100%. Of course, there is very few possibility of doing gapping because the germination percentage is very high. Farmers who planted it are asking for it this time around, and they are promising to take maybe even large, in large bulk.
We tested to order it because of demand from the farmers. And then the second thing, there was field days that I've done. Those who have seen it in the field are able to come and advising us to stop for them.
The ministry, we are in charge of the areas as concerns extension, and we do promotion through field day demonstrations, field days, barasas, and maybe when there is any other meeting, we promote it in those areas.
One big effort really is to encourage the local farmers who are used to certain varieties, that the scientists or science has developed other new varieties which can yield more, and therefore they go for them. Because one of the problems we are facing is people get traditionally used to a certain variety.
I personally believe that seed is a speed business. If you have a good product, it should be go to the farmers quickly, and it should be spread also very quickly. And the way AATF handled the whole, they not only gave us the very quickly the parent seed, but also they supplied the final product.
We are funding AATF to promote this technology. We believe in this variety and this technology. I must say I'm very impressed. The variety is doing very well. Farmers are impressed. The yields are good. And farmers have expressed interest to invest in the variety, which is very good, and this will go a long way to help them get enough food. And those who even will plant a big acreage will be able to get surplus for sale to meet their domestic needs.
It is through these partnerships that we can reach more farmers. Like these promotions we are going through, if Agra hadn't come in, wouldn't be here standing, because we had a limited scope of area to cover, and that's adding more value to what we would have done, and covering more farmers, especially like here in Western Kenya where we are. So there is a lot of compliment that we are getting from this support.
One challenge I think which is cutting across is the seed. Right now, there are very few seed companies producing this seed. Actually, most of them are just bulking, which means they'll be able to put seed on market on their own in the next 2 years. So if they don't, then the farmers will lose interest.
We have a seed production roadmap that has been developed, and we are looking forward to availing sufficient seed within the next coming years. And also we have also given the parental lines, what we call parental lines, to other seed companies to also start producing their own certified seed. So we are doing that two-pronged approach to ensure that seed will be there and sustainably in the market.
With the partnership that we have created, the project, the seed company and the farmers are in for a good time in terms of having very good high quality seed. And we increase their productivity, the yield, and of course, in the long run, we expect that this will improve their livelihood, improve their income. Many who cannot take their children to school, obviously, will be able to take their children to school because they will now have more yield, more income being produced through the project.